Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda.
Hey, Scott.
You beat me out of medical again. How long?
Not long. Weeks. Enough to get started.
Started on what? The Hyperion? Meridian?
The ship is part of... They're both our home now.
One and the same. Capital ship, capital city.
Hmm.
A home for humanity.
And others.
We did it, Dad. Are you okay? You and Sam?
Our connection has been restored. I am once again able to help the Pathfinder activate remnant technology.
But does he still need to?
Not technically?
I adapted to use remnant without him, but it's not advisable.
Dr. Carlyle estimates an 80% risk of further hemorrhaging.
Further being the alarming part. For you and me both, Scott.
Pathfinder, the Nexus leaders are waiting for us.
Go on. I bet it's real important.
It always is.
Station sabotage. Confront Dale. Contagion. Confront the Rokar leader. Epilogue. Home and away. Talk to your squad and crew. 0 out of 10. Okay, we do have more stuff to go. Alright. I thought it was just going to be a few things. I still have Jal and PB as squad members here. Oh, we got stuff. Alright, let's look at these first. Journal. That's on hold. Carry. Epilogue. Home and away. It's been some time since the battle against the Archon, and Meridian is beginning to function as a hub for humanity. Everyone is building on the foundation you gave them. Talk to your squad and crew. 0 out of 10. What happened with Contagion? Contagion and something else. Station sabotage. I wish I could search. I'm not even... I probably passed it. That's infection, not contagion. Why is it acting like there's a new part in those quests? I know I finished them. Station sabotage is way past. I probably... Well, at least I can put this stuff in alphabetical order. Contagion. Alright, we did that. It's all done. Shrug. So, Codex. Finding a home. The battle for Meridian. With the help of your brother and countless allies, you successfully defeated the Archon and his forces, but we just left him laying there because we're a bunch of friggin' idiots. Captain Nozomi Dunn bravely sacrificed herself to ensure the Hyperion was brought down safely. The ship, as Port Meridian, is now a permanent home for the Initiative. Oh, sweet. Nekmordrak. Anything else on Nek? Saving the galaxy from the Archon has given Drak a new sense of purpose. Cora. With your mission to find Meridian a success, Cora remains ready and willing to face the next adventure. You and Cora have the utmost trust and respect for each other and make a strong team. Some reason specifically, just these three. Vetra. With your recent successes against the Kett, Vetra has really begun to believe that, despite all that's come before, you have a chance to make it in Helios. She showed you a quiet spot on a cliff overlooking Kadara Port and expressed her pride at being a part of your team and, hopefully, a friend. Oh, definitely, friend. You've triumphed over everything Helios has thrown at you, And you know you'll continue to do so, with the Pathfinder team and with people like Vetra at your back. Okay. Agent of Change. The Primus Offer. You made a deal with the Kett Primus for a kill code to use against Archon's forces. Oh, that was that code, right, that we used. You took the opportunity to weaken the Archon's position during the final battle of Meridian. It is yet to be determined how this deal with the devil will play out. Some devil. The Andromeda Initiative. Known associates. PB? It doesn't look like anything is meant to be. Scott Ryder. Scott eventually awoke safely. Medical records show slow but promising improvement in his condition. However, sharing identical implants and similar physiology made Scott a target for the Archon. After attacking the Nexus and hijacking the Hyperion, the Archon took Scott captive, intending to use him to provide access to Meridian. Fortunately, you were able to intervene. Though injured, Scott is projected to make a full recovery. Yeah, you better, Buster. Nothing new with Suvi, right? Yeah. There's no Suvi scene. I mean, we just, like, made out and stuff. It's not like... I mean, I've heard stories about some of the other characters. Oh. Kett. Data on the biology, etc. The Archon. Yeah, still alive. It is now understood that the Archon's single-minded efforts to find and control remnant technology have diverted resources from the Kett conquest of Helios. From gathered intelligences, the Archon's second-in-command, the Primus, right, not the Archon shield, believes their leader's interest in their remnant has become an obsession that threatens their subjugation of the Angara. Probably read that part already. The Archon was killed at the Battle for Meridian. Lies. After almost gaining control of the facility, we now face the consequences of his death. Though the Kett are still reeling from the loss of their leader, the Primus has reportedly succeeded him and intends to pursue Kett interests in Helios. Oh, nice. I mean, that was him getting up, right, Primus? Yeah, that wasn't the Primus. With the Archon dead, the Primus is now de facto leader of the Kett forces in the Helios Cluster. Freed from the distraction of investigating and defending remnant structures, we can expect the Kett to remain a clear and present danger under her leadership. Oh, awesome. The Remnant. Remnant Colonel Device. Oh. Found in a defunct remnant manufacturing center in the heart of an active volcano, this device is unique among the remnant technology discovered to date. It appears to contain a raw remnant programming kernel which could offer unprecedented insight into how remnant technology performs seemingly impossible feats. PB has expressed her determination to study the device and find ways to utilize it. She believes, on strong evidence, that the device can facilitate her attempts to merge remnant technology with her own. PB and Gil have been successful in utilizing the device to augment Tempest systems and enhance your ability to control remnant vessels in the battle to take Meridian. The device's potential to unlock how the remnant acquire programming and evolve our ability to interface and appropriate remnant hardware and systems is unparalleled. PB's research could lead to impressive advances in years to come. Sounds good. Plants and locations. The Scourge can't clear. Let's see if there's anything. Yeah, there's Meridian. Meridian is a construct akin to a Dyson sphere, a vast hollow shell encompassing a power source that provides heat and light to lush green biomes in the interior. My early studies of Jardan records suggest Meridian was their laboratory and seed world, connected to each vault and constantly monitoring the progress of life there. However, even at quantum processing speeds, it will take decades to sift through all the Meridian's accumulated data. With the Hyperion crash landed inside, humanity has a significant stake in Meridian's future and has founded Port Meridian, a largely human settlement based around the Hyperion crash site. Right, Port Meridian, speaking of. Meridian is now the home name of both the Jardan Seed World Shell and the largely human port and city within. Okay, largely human. The architectural center of the port is the repurposed superstructure of the Ark Hyperion, which is being converted to stationary housing and research facilities. The controlled crash of the Hyperion by Captain Nozomi Dunn marked the first complete deployment and landing of an initiative Ark in Andromeda, effectively designating Meridian a human capital. Adaptation of the former Ark Hyperion is ongoing, as is the deployment of its 20,000 sleepers. Yeah, so it's too bad she couldn't strap herself into that chair. Damn. I guess no one else died as a result of that. Anything else? Ships and vehicles? Ark Hyperion. Ark Hyperion crashed on Meridian in the battle against the Archon. The Ark was decommissioned, the vessel's internal structures are now being adapted for future industrial and residential deployment, redesignated as Port Meridian. Okay. Still not working. Okay. Email terminal, anything new? Oh yeah. Please add your thanks for the team. Initiative, Meridian Helios. We almost didn't make it, but thanks to the bravery of the Pathfinder team, we have well and truly arrived. Add your voice and gratitude. Let them know that they have affected lives. Who wrote that? Thank you so much. I'm relieved beyond measure that my involvement was not necessary. Bran Caven. There are no words. Waking up to this was amazing. G. Daniels, Posey Roth. Okay, these are all the awakened people, I guess. Seems like the thing to do, Candy Jensen. Forever, honestly, LP. Danke. To the team, H. Lowell. You're the best. Way to plant the flag, Cami Tabart. Simply thanks, Pam Aberdeen. Knew it'd work out. They said we were good as dead, but I didn't see it, so I knew we'd come back from the brink. See Pernia. We're going to make it work. M.K. Magnuson. I wonder if this is from the development team who wrote this. Thank you, thank you. Knew we'd make it. Lori, Navy, and Ira. Thanks, thanks, thanks. Can't say it enough. H.L. So grateful. Go team. W.P. Grazi. Amazing ride, B. Garanti. So hopeful. Came here to be someone. Now we can. L. Lowell, V. Jess. Moving forward. Being stuck in stasis was rough, but it was nothing compared to what you did. Thank you. Paul Mugman. Thank you. Just thanks. Pony Moses. Pony Moses. You're the best. Thanks for picking up my slack. Junior would have been amazed. Eric Camber. You're the best. You can drive my boat anytime. Captain I. Can't say enough. This is stupid. Heroes don't need thanks from me. I'm just normal. D. Aguda. So grateful. Your team is a lifesaver. They probably get that a lot. Key Tetarenko. A great story, Pathfinder. I'm going to write a book about this. V. Tethras. Oh, God. Going to write a book about it. I wonder if this is a nod to the novel that came out. I wonder if that's sold. I think it was giving a Mass Effect Andromeda novel. Thank you, team. Can't believe it. Jeng Anguda. Words aren't enough. A new life because of you. Suki Medeiros. Like they said, a small thanks from no one important. Yet. El Severa. Sopas, Pathfinder. A light in the darkness. Tujela Allen. ZZ Pathfinder team. There's no way to thank you for the lives ahead of us. Jian Lu. Thank you. This was a strange journey to be on. See May. Winners get raspberries. Team, finding a home is brilliant. R. Jenny plus Whittle. There's a link to an animated texture of the Meridian Sphere with an added arm gesturing with two fingers. Sam has hopefully noted that, while awesome, it is not to scale. Thanks, I guess. I could have helped if I had a Sam. C. Hawk. Connor Hawk? This was and is the best. Glad to be back in the game. M. Fentan. My thanks. A radiant victory, team. Thank you all. Jin Z. Jen, not Jin. Glad to be home. So glad to have made it. Thank you, team. Bahajomi. Me too. So many thanks, Alora. I'll make it matter. Just like you, Pathfinder. Just like you. Donald Sutherland? Thanks for this chance. I'm going to do great things. Singwa. Please read. Just wanted to say you did a good job. Madeline Schmidt. Elation. All times are 314, Pi. All dates are merengue. Space is custer and sort of flaky. MFK. Okay. Just a simple thank you. Like all the rest, it's just a thank you from a would-be pioneer. Hami Okiro. Inspirational. If anyone asks, your family. A. Hender. Forever grateful. The chance we all needed. A. Gend. So thankful. Anyone wants to complain about the job the team did, tell them to take it to me. Helen Watt? Wait. I can't stop crying. It's so beautiful. Ciala Kennedy. Happy landing day. Let's blow the roof off the place. Anders. Simple thanks, over and over. I'm a carpenter. My daughter's a pilot. We're alive. Thanks. That's all. Benny T. Nice planet. Inside out or not, feels like New Earth to me. B. Alba. I wanted home. I got family. Thanks to the team. I hope you found family, too. Elvoth. Much love. New worlds. Can't wait. Jatori Reese. Brave as shit. Pathfinder team is all hero, as far as I care. D.B. Cumbernold. P.S. I'm pushing this live to the outposts. Bet they want to say thanks, too. List updating. Awaiting database upgrade. Speed of entries has exceeded civilian buffer. See? Make the radioactive canisters inert. I did that so long ago. Why is it popping up? Well, that was interesting. A lot of thanks and stuff. Remnant derelict model. Cool. Is there anything new here?
Your father's personal logs.
This is all the same stuff, right? I don't think this terminal was even here before. Oh, Scott Ryder's right there.
Your father's first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Halleck's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Crazy times.
Calibration achieved. I apologize for any disorientation.
Are we back to normal?
The definition of that word is in constant flux.
Okay. I didn't even know he wanted us to do that. I'm not paying attention. Pathfinder protocols restored. Capacity developing. Ping received, returned. Implant status verified. The implant's connection is functioning within established parameters. Interface assist has been restored. That you snoring?
Go on. I need some rest.
Okay, Grouchy. Grouchy, we just won the galaxy here.
The decision isn't yours.
Neither is it yours. That is the point, isn't it?
What decision?
Pathfinder, you're late.
I can't get one day off around here?
Save the cluster, straight back to work. I get it.
It must seem like that, but this wouldn't be possible without you.
As outposts become colonies, the cluster needs its own voice, a true council.
And while I maintain that it is premature, we must nominate an interim ambassador to represent concerns outside the Nexus. Or rather, you must nominate someone.
What does this position entail?
Interim ambassador? To what and for who?
To the Nexus. The eventual goal was always a galactic council, but Meridian has accelerated concerns.
An Ark has landed. The vaults may make outposts self-sufficient, and we can't claim to represent a sovereign Angara. An interim ambassador would represent concerns outside the Nexus, until elections when we can all step aside.
At the appropriate time.
There should be a vote, though.
If this person is supposed to represent people, shouldn't the people have a say?
That is precisely why we need your backing.
We can't impose a vote on the Angara. Or even Kadara. Elidan? Won't happen.
But you've acted for everyone. If you endorse a name, some may disagree, but they will trust it as a starting point.
Someone to speak for Helios.
I put forward Pathfinder Hager. I'd suggest you, but someone might think you killed the Archon to elevate yourself. We can't allow the appearance of that.
Okay.
But Hager keeps the position, and the timeline, in the Nexus family.
Bradley. I don't even remember who Bradley is. Maybe none of us that came across. Maybe you should go to the people who've been here all this time, have been suffering under the Kett. So maybe an Angara? The Moshai?
The Angara need to help define the process. It's their right. Plus the Moshai would help solidify relations.
We're already partnered, thanks to your efforts against the Rokar.
All the more reason to focus on our own issues.
August Bradley. I remember who that is. I don't know. These are all good choices. I don't actually disapprove of any of this, but I'm supporting the Moshai.
If we're going to treat Helios like a home, we need to acknowledge whose home it is. I won't name anyone. I support asking the Moshai to act as interim ambassador.
Meridian's opening day, and we're surrendering how much influence?
You asked.
That's the point, you colonial ward.
Wow.
Scott is feeling better? Good. This decision, the policy and protocol, that's not what your victory was about. There's more to life than this.
That's true. Oh my, there's people all over. Kalo, Drak, Vetra, Liam, Jal, Cora, Suvi, PB up here, Lexi, Gil. Alright. Oh, I got additional tasks? Oh no, that was already there. Never mind. Amcor?
Integration of Hyperion systems is ongoing. Our SAM node will be accessible on return visits to Meridian.
Okey-doke.
You're lucky the Pathfinder fixed your shit.
Fixed my shit?
Fixed your shit.
Who even are you?
Who even are you? What did I fix? Kalo.
Ryder. Enjoying the fruits of your labor? You deserve it.
Thanks, Kalo.
Doing anything.
The Tempest is getting some much-needed service. I thought I'd leave them to it. But I wouldn't miss the big day. Meridian looks so different out of the cockpit. I think I understand better why you do what you do.
Why would I ask him if he wants a career change? Oh, because he says... It looks different. Yeah. You want a career change? Because he's gonna say absolutely not. He loves being a pilot, tell you that much.
Thinking of trading in your pilot's chair for some muddy boots?
Not even slightly. I know what I'm good for. I don't pretend to understand everything, but Meridian must have opened a lot of doors. Not all of them safe. I want you to know that it'll be my privilege to keep flying you to them.
I appreciate that.
It means a lot that you want to stick with us, Kallo.
Of course. And keeping my ship is a plus. I've learned a lot from you, Ryder. And Gil. Though, please don't tell him that. Things will change now. But that's all right. Nothing's ever really lost.
Guess not.
I'll be ready when you are.
Okie dokie.
You'll get no argument from me.
She's not going to give any argument. Alright. Back behind me are some others. Darla Vas Hyperion. You've got a... She's got a name. She's got the name of the, crap. I can't remember. I played the whole game without these people. I miss them. The, crap. I'll put in annotations. Well, I can't remember the name. Vas Normandy. I don't know. She's named herself like I can't remember. Oh, God. Like Tally's race. I can't remember the name. Tally Zora Vas Normandy. We got Darla Vas Hyperion.
Up straight, everyone. This is the guest of honor.
Like you have to tell anyone that.
Hunter, this is our opening. Let there be some sense of ceremony.
As I was about to say, hello, Pathfinder. I am Chief of Operations, Ayora Pile.
Second Wave Placements Officer, Darla Vas Hyperion.
Hunter Carey, Reconstruction.
Okay. I'm gonna ask questions. Placements Officer?
Darla Vas Hyperion, Placements Officer.
As our developments in the cluster grow more sophisticated, proper matching of sleeper and assignment will be vital. My mission is to ensure compatibility and fulfillment.
When are you changing your name to Vas Meridian?
I keep Vas Hyperion to honor the ship that brought us here, as my godparents would want.
Oh.
Just saying we're staying.
Please forgive Hunter. He is an ass.
Okay.
Darla Vas Hyperion, Placements Officer.
Oh.
As our developments in the cluster, my mission is to ensure compatibility and fulfillment.
Yeah, so she's, I guess her godparents were of, Tally's race? I can't remember the name. That's killing me. What? It's on the tip of my tongue. Chief of Operations?
Ayora Pillay. You're in charge of Meridian?
That's a big statement. I will oversee the operations and establishment of our port. Exploration and study of the... interesting substructure will be handled by Initiative R&D. I'm told that may take lifetimes. We'll ensure that we have them. That's what I trained for.
Hmm. Quarian. God damn, why couldn't I remember Quarian? Okay, reconstruction?
Hunter Carey, can I get some clarification on reconstruction?
Sure thing. I'm tasked with turning this once proud vessel into the future proud human capital.
It's more complicated than that.
No, it's a structural and organizational nightmare. Which is job security, which is perfect. Come back in a year. This'll be a galactic hub. You won't know where the Hyperion ends and Meridian begins.
Huh. And what's this about second wave?
This is the first I've heard of the term, second wave.
It isn't literal. There have been several groups deployed for outposts. Second wave is about the staged evolution of the initiative.
First wave out of cryo, structural support and generalists. Food and fences. Second wave is organizational. Less generalists, more specialists.
More paperwork.
It's needed to rapidly advance. I'm not spending a generation on the range.
I love her accent. Well, I'm glad to meet you all.
Sounds like Meridian is in good hands.
I can only read the reports of how you brought us this opportunity, but rest assured, we will not waste it.
Yes. Thank you, Pathfinder.
Aye, what they said.
What they said.
Thank you, Pathfinder. I'll pay it forward, I swear.
Sorry, it looked like I was rubbing myself all over you. Got more email terminal. Interfacing long-term damage. Reporting Dr. Harry Carlyle. Assisting Dr. Lexi Tapero and Sam. The ability to activate remnant technology without the SAM is an amazing adaptation, but the writer's siblings have worked that muscle very hard in a limited time. Sam reports that at least in the Pathfinder's case, normal brain function has not been affected. However, we can observe scarring on the occipital lobe and the hippocampus. That's not good. This fits with assumptions about remnant, re-interocular transfer, and long-term memory. There are also stress markers throughout the corpus callosum, if I'm saying that right, suggesting remnant activation requires some deviation from cooperative hemispheric function. I'm not going there in this report. That split-brain business has always skeeved me out. Recommendations. Ongoing monitoring of the writer siblings. Restriction of remnant interfacing unless Sam assists. That was one hell of a Hail Mary. And we all got lucky. Let's not push it. Notes to shut Tan up. 1. What did the Archon actually do, and will it kill us? Please summarize this in a form that Director Tan can easily digest. I'd like him off my ass at our earliest convenience. We're examining everything, including the Archon's eye, his omni-tool equivalent. Many functions remain unknown and seem specific to exaltation. Forwarded to genetics, Krogan. It appeared to allow the Archon to externally manipulate the SAM connection, but it's unclear how useful the Archon's own data will be. He clearly wasn't aware how difficult it would be to attempt to interface with Meridian, despite observing the hemorrhaging the Pathfinder suffered while interfacing with far smaller remnant elements. The data from SAM suggests the Archon managed to poke some form of maintenance protocol. The remnant that he summoned were enacting some form of corrupted cleaning behavior. The architect was itself in some state of construction and disrepair. As for Meridian's activation, that was not the Archon. The simplest analogy is that touching any system was akin to approaching a motion-detecting light. As soon as ships approached, Meridian began to transition out of dormancy. Well, he's... God, he was making it all about him. I did it! Ah, ha, ha. Well, it's just because you were the first there, and it sensed you were there. Stupid Archon. Notes to shut Tan up, too. What did the Archon actually do, and will it kill us? Continued, could Meridian be weaponized? Technically, anything can be weaponized if you throw it hard enough. Note, do not say that to Tan. We're getting into who are the Jardan and what did they intend. Territory. Signs point to the Meridian being a life lab or seed world, and that includes aggressive terraforming through network vaults. This could be dangerous, but while it is attempting to look at the purge state of vaults and wonder if that could be turned into a planet-wide event, we've seen no evidence of that capability. Do not send the below section to Tan. Not helpful. Some pendant says that ever since the 2037 outbreak on Earth, every military-run human lab has had protocols for emergency sterilization of facilities. Solarians have similar fail-safes, again in military facilities. Has anyone asked whether the Meridian Sphere and connected vaults were considered civilian enterprises? We know that the Scourge was a weapon and that the Jardan were deliberately targeted, but we've no indication why. Seems like we'd want to know that. Angara showing affinity. Useful? Security evaluation. Apex collected. Status ongoing. We've already hosted multiple Angaran factional heads. Separate concerns have been logged for two of those. Panel Project and Aya 1. We're making liberal use of their expertise. It's possible that some of Meridian was designed for them to access. They can't, of course, but they've been no end of help about adapting our technology to integrate somewhat into the Meridian power structure. The Angara welcome any access, and we're glad to host it. No doubt some of them are interested in their connection to the Jardin. It's jarring enough to have a creator, but one that was here only centuries ago? I'd be all over this place. End log. Angara showing affinity. Alert. Security addendum. SAM override. Attendees. Data missing. Speaker 1. The revelations on Havarl are problematic. We've never encountered a species designed to pass information through their genetics, nor do we know the limits of this function. Speaker 2. If they retain information, can we access it? Maybe the Angara can remember how to work Meridian. Speaker 1. That isn't the right question. If they can retain information, can they also receive it? Receive instruction? Have they already? Speaker 2. Well, that's just... You mean sleeper agents. Speaker 1. Shut that off and wipe. End log. Interfacing. Budgeting request. Interfacing going forward. Special budgeting request. Reporting. Data missing. SAM override. As of today, the Ryder siblings are still the only people able to directly interface with Remnant, and only the SAM connection allows the Pathfinder to do it without damage. It is a self-limiting adaptation, but there was a time when there was only one human biotic, and the mistake of the day was to say she was the only one rather than the first. This ability is demonstrably trainable. We must assume that, like biotics, it is something that can be assisted and will spread in future. To avoid the violence of Subject White, and to avoid the mistakes of bat training in Gagarin, we must begin preparations now. We live inside a machine made by aliens we can't comprehend. The next person to control Remnant cannot be an accident. Welcome to New Zero. Let's be ready. Last one. Autopsy and handling. Subject, Archon. Really? We did an autopsy? I thought that he got up. Reporting exobiologist Dr. Viara Pelina. Subject, the Archon. Species, Kett. Age, unknown. Cause of death. The jokes will cease. The cause of death is not Pathfinder. I may be second wave and didn't see the fight, but there are no monsters in my morgue. This being will be afforded the respect of our profession, especially since the cause of death could have direct consequences, should our Pathfinder continue to manipulate Remnant or others training in their use. While the structures of the Kett brain are unknown in purpose and, perhaps, design, the damage to tissue is obvious. When the devices of Meridian were denied an external power source, they in part drew from the Archon's own augmentations. This repeated surge and transfer inflicted internal burns and, shockingly, lacerations. So who the hell got up? However, it is my opinion that these injuries, while severe, were survivable. I say this because I have personal history with treatment of biotics who have strained too far and damaged themselves. The fatal element here is different. The use of Remnant is not just a physical strain. It seems to draw some part of the mind into the manipulated element, a division on consciousness. I am in theoretical territory here, but this is my analysis. The Archon overextended his faculties within Meridian. When the Pathfinder took control of the power, the Archon was not just depowered, he was, for lack of a better term, severed from himself. I need more time with the Archon's remains, and dedicated facilities, a full team. The study of this one being could last lifetimes. So who the hell got up at the end of the... after the credits?
I'm looking forward to the future, our future. This is why I'm in the initiative.
Well, good for you. Just good for you.